I'm Serena here for WW Magazine, and today we are talking about Disney World for adults. Is Disney World just for kids? Some people have claimed that it is. Well, today we're going to find out the best things that you can do on your next adults-only Disney World vacation. Let's get started.
Number one, rent a boat. There are a lot of different boats that are available to rent at the Disney World marinas. You can do two-seater Sea Racer-style boats, 10-seater pontoon boats, and the campground even has kayaks and canoes available for rent. They rent by the hour at many of the various deluxe resorts, and you don't need to be a guest of those resorts to rent them. The large pontoon boats can actually be rented for special fireworks cruises. You get private viewing up close from the water, and you can even go parasailing at Disney. Number two, take a walk on the boardwalk. A place many people skip, this area behind World Showcase at Epcot has so many hidden gems, particularly suited for adults, including Jelly Roll's Piano Bar, Atlantic Dance Hall, and the gorgeous Abracadabra Bar. Particularly lovely in the evening, the boardwalk is a great place to stroll along, grab a margarita, watch the sunset, and enjoy the various entertainers that come out in the evenings. Number three, visit the themed bars and lounges. There are so many great themed bars at Walt Disney World. One of our favorites we mentioned on the boardwalk, the mysterious Abracadabra Bar. It's even got its own backstory. It's themed after the Golden Age of Magic, so think Houdini-era decor and style. If you look closely at the details in Abracadabra Bar, you'll notice that it tells the story of a 1940s group of boardwalk illusionists who vanished into thin air in that very spot right after a performance, never to be heard from again. Along the walls, you'll see vintage show posters with the missing magicians, but if you look closely at the posters, at certain key points each hour, the magicians in them disappear. It's a great little hidden gem to visit. Some of our other favorite bars, we love Baseline Tap House at Hollywood Studios, Nomad Lounge at Animal Kingdom, La Cava del Tequila at Epcot's Mexico is a super fun spot to get a nice cold drink. And we love the brand new Wine Bar George at Disney Springs. Number four, enjoy the festivals of Epcot. There are four different festivals that happen during the year at Epcot. First is Festival of the Arts that runs January and February. Spring, we have Flower and Garden. The very popular Food and Wine Festival happens every fall. And then the Festival of the Holidays takes place in the winter. While these festivals aren't just for adults, they do offer a lot of entertainment that is particularly geared for adults. Things like the artisan and crafts workshops that you can take during Festival of the Arts, the gardening classes that happen for Flower and Garden, and the wine pairing and the chef meals that you can experience during Food and Wine Festival. Food and Wine Festival is particularly popular for adults, and all of these festivals offer a great, fresh new way to experience Epcot. Number five. Book a meal at a fine dining restaurant. Some of the best restaurants in Orlando can be found inside Walt Disney World. This surprises a lot of people, but Disney has taken dining way beyond theme parks. There are so many amazing places to choose from that particularly cater to adults. Some of our favorites, Le Cellier at Canada in Epcot, Chefs de France in Epcot's France, Tiffin's at Animal Kingdom, and of course, the top tier Victoria and Albert's at the Grand Floridian. These restaurants offer the perfect place to take a break from your theme park touring, relax, and have a really great meal. Number six, take a specialty tour. There are many special tours available to take at Disney World. One of my personal favorites, the Backstage Magic Tour. It's a one-of-a-kind VIP look at the inner workings of the entire Walt Disney World Resort. It's a 7-hour tour that shows you things like the Magic Kingdom Utilidors, the Creative Costuming Department, and even the central shops where they repair all of the attractions. Another great one, the Behind the Scenes Tour at Epcot. This guided 1-hour tour happens in the Land Pavilion. It shows you the greenhouses that you see in the Living with the Land attractions. There's also other nature experiences like the Wild Africa Trek in Animal Kingdom. Any of these tours can be a great way to enhance your next Disney World vacation. 7, drinking around the world. Now, this is often the first one people think of when we talk about adults-only fun at Disney World. World Showcase is so well-suited for adults, with a different drink and food offerings in every single land as you walk around the lagoon. Many people call this drinking around the world. Lots of great options to try. A few of our personal favorites: the Violet Sake in Japan, the Grapefruit Beer in Germany, and we love the Avocado Margarita in Mexico. I know, it sounds weird. Just try it. 8, choose an elegant resort for your stay. Disney has tons of great resorts, and they're all pretty awesome. But there are several that are definitely particularly suited for adults. Maybe it's their location near the World Showcase, or maybe it's their food and drink options, or the nightlife that they have access to. Our particular favorites, we love the Boardwalk. If you haven't noticed during this list, the Boardwalk features prominently in our adults-only vacations. The Boardwalk Resort just has so much to offer for an adults-only trip. We also love the Swan and Dolphin, which is also in the Epcot area resorts. And of course, the ultimate in posh, the Grand Floridian Resort. 9, stay out late. One of the best perks of being at Disney without kids is not having any bedtimes to worry about. There are many areas at Disney that offer great options for late night entertainment. One of my personal favorites is I love to stay at Magic Kingdom late. Even after official closing time, you get to enjoy the castle and Main Street all empty. It's so beautiful at night. We also love the Boardwalk for nighttime entertainment. And Disney Springs has become quite the hub of nightlife entertainment. In fact, they have lots of bars and restaurants that stay hopping until 2 in the morning. 10, relax. One thing that kids don't usually want to do is take it slow and relax. But when you make time for that, it can really make your Disney trip feel like an actual vacation. Whether it's lounging poolside at your resort, walking along the Seven Seas Lagoon, or just finding a park bench and people watching, all of those are a great way to spend an afternoon and can end up being one of the real highlights of your vacation.
So those are our best tips for your next adults-only vacation time here at Walt Disney World. But now we want to hear from you. What are your favorite things to do? Go ahead and leave us a comment below. We would love to hear your thoughts. If you haven't yet, make sure you subscribe to our channel so you don't miss a future video. I'm Serena here for WW Magazine. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you real soon. Bye-bye.